Welcome back on Dermot. Today I want to propose you a video about
The unboxing and review about the issue number 41 released for the series of Warhammer 40K Warhammer Conquest, that is a combination of Games Workshop and Hachette. This is the first part of the Blockbuster Crawler. I want to remind you that in this case you had to have both the 41 and the 42. It's not like the Rhino where you had the vehicle complete on one number and the accessories to the other. About the Rhino, I remember you that you can find the link in the description about that issue. And I want also to make some declaring. First, it's that as usual, I don't like this. There is no separation, no protection from the issue and the model, as usual. And this is quite cheap to prevent this to be ruined and so on. I don't like such. The second one is that the releasing about these issues has been changed for now. I don't know how much it lasts, and that is that the issues would be released one each 2 weeks instead of one each week, because there has been problems with the lockdown and so on. So at least for Italy, there will be such problems that are going to be having for this releasing. Still, I think that it's okay, because at least you can make a bit of briefing having them released. And there is also a bonus that you can have time to understand which numbers you want and find them, because it's becoming a bit difficult to be able to find such numbers. In fact, I have still some numbers that I'm waiting for and I not yet received. In fact, I'll bring you the numbers when I receive them. Still, it's really quite amazing, because you save a lot of money. Remember this when you try this Warhammer Conquest issues, because they let you really save a lot of money for the same model that you can buy from the Games Workshop. So pay attention to such. And now we can open and see the contents. And now we can see the part of the model. So we can see that there is a part that it's we can see the internal part, and there are so the part about this, the trace. We can find the part about the external part of the model, this one, and some other details. So it's really quite interesting, but still you need the other half of the model itself. So this time you don't have any excuse, you have to buy both of them to have them. Anyway, I think that it's really a quite an amazing model. I really like a lot such model, and so I decided to have one for myself, because I needed for my Death Guard army. I don't want to collect the Death Guard army, but still it's becoming a Death Guard army. So okay, we take note about this. So now we can move this and see the content inside the issue itself. So the issue itself, as we said, it's about the Blockbuster Crawler. We can flip and open, we can find the contents, we can find the description about the Blockbuster Crawler, that you can see it like a sort of Death Guard Vindicator. It's almost the same. Here we can find a lot of information about it. Here the description about the weapons of the Blockbuster Crawler, so we can have quite a lot of information about. And here, as I said, all the weapons that are in here, we can find the background about the Space Wolves. So at least we have new rules about, with a lot of information about the different we can say holes of the Space Wolf. Here we can find about the Fenris Zone of War, and about this you have to remember that there has been a lot of releasing about this case, because we have this volumes for the Zone of Fenris. Remember, these are because I'm crazy and I bought them, but it's not essential. If you start, it's only way to make you understand that there are a lot of things that you can improve if you find some themes about. If you are not interested, not worry, they are not something that you have to have. Simply, it's a way to make you understand how much there is that you can really bring more to your knowledge. Here we have so about or whatever you see before, but a little we can say summary about. And here we can find how to build the FlegBus crawler. So we can find what we have in this case about it, and we can find that we need the other part. So pay attention to this, because without the other part you'll not be able to adjust everything. But remember that you have to keep these instructions, because they are needed to build the model, but also to understand if you can modify or something else the model itself. So if you can make that, you can magnetize, you can personalize it. So I think that it's really quite good. Here we have about to give under layer of color, so how to highlight the miniature. So when you started to paint, you'll go to see. For example, this miniature, I'm waiting for that it make me brought, because I'm waiting for this because I like a lot, but still waiting. And here we can find how with little tricks you can really make more detailed, more nice to see the miniature itself. So really little things can make it develop your painting. So we have really little things, really little detailed, and they can change completely your model. And here we can find new rules and new battle plan to play with, so that you can try, for example, the scenic elements that has been brought to you, and how to use these scenic elements. So it's really a nice way to understand how you can bring on the things that you are going to utilize. There are a lot of things. And here we can find the battle plan that you can try with new things that you can try to use for such battle plan. Here it's the icon of this Warhammer Conquest, this image. As usual, you can cut this part or so on and use this as a poster. And then we have the parts that will be released next. Sincerely, okay, this one I yet said, you must buy to finish this now, this model, otherwise it's even not half, because you miss a lot of parts that are the must. Here we have the next one, that it's the Thermic Plasma Regulators, and sincerely I'm still deciding if I'm interested in them or not, because they're really quite amazing, I like a lot, but still I don't need them, so I have not yet decided, but surely it's something that if you are missing shining elements, buy, because they can give you a lot of really interesting part, because you can gain a lot of characterization in your building, in your way to make your field and so on. Not because the rules, but because the aspect, because they are really quite amazing. And you can save a bit of money you buying them, also because they are not so simple to find. So give a sight eventually. So what to say about this number? I think that as I said, it's a must if you want to have this vehicle, because you can save a lot of money, and you need to remember that if you buy this one, you need also the next one, because you want to finish such model, otherwise it would be a pity. Or if you don't want that this model becomes a sort of ruins where to build around the things. So but anyway, a good thing. I want to remember also you that about the rules. The rules in Warhammer Conquest here are related about the 8th edition. It has been going to be released the 9th edition in this month. So remember that it's July when I registered this video. And remember that so the rules that you find, they have been a bit of change. It doesn't mean that they are useless, because you can start to play even if it's the previous version of the game. It's not so changed, okay, there are a lot of changes, but it's not so changed that you miss a lot. So you can start to enter using them and then adjusting the rules to your needing later, because this is a way to collect, to start the hobby. It's not necessarily a way that you can use this and go to tournaments, because if you pay attention to this, you are going to have an army that has been released in 2 years, even more now. But remember, not be in a hurry. You can collect the scenic elements, you can collect the models that you like. Not be pressed by the fact that you had to add the latest release and so on. Take your time, paint, have fun, try and so on, because the ideas that are inset here, step by step, you can use them to know also the next game. The things that you can find to play with little shenanigans and so on, to adjust the battle plans and so on, they can be a really nice play also to after when you develop. You can try them because there are missions for some little models to play with. So it's really more than you can think. Not make that okay, there is something completely new, I completely forget about this. Because a lot of mods has to be released about this. It has been going to be useful anyway. And I want to remember you that the version of the edition can change. The mods remain. So not base your needing, your things that you want to buy. Only based on the things that you think they are a strength in the game. But think about you'd like to play with. I think that it's better and it's a, I can say, healthier way to play the game. Even if, remember, I'm a still competitive player. So,
from DynoMod, it's everything. I invite you to put a like on this video, to subscribe to the channel, to ring the bell, and to comment this video if you are interested in something about this video or you want to suggest me some arguments for other videos. I hope to see you again to the next time.